നദിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിൻ മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴിയും ഒഴുകാമൊഴിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിൻ മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴി പടരാം പവിഴക്കരയും താണ്ടേ Color your life. ഒഴുകാമൊലിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിൻ മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴിയും ഒഴുകാമൊലിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിനൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴി പടരാം പവിഴക്കരയും താണ്ടി ഗാനരാഗമായി റേഡിയോ റംഗ് കളർ യുവർ ലൈഫ്.
The pandemic has brought in unprecedented challenges in life. It has been tough for young kids who are literally chained inside the four walls with electronic gadgets for company. Their family, their outing, their friends, their peer group, they are missing everything. They do not have the freedom to mingle. And since February, I have personally known many of my students who have not stepped out of their home. Time has really become a challenging situation right now, like never before. Mental health is a huge concern. Well-being of students, teachers and parents are equally important for a perfect balance. And today, on this Radio Rang performance, we have two counselors who will be speaking on the mental well-being of students and to know more about what exactly is the role of a counselor in today's testing time. So ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome in today's Radio Rang presentation, and let me take the privilege and the honor to welcome and introduce two very renowned counselors who are on this particular island. And without me talking much, let me give them the stage to introduce themselves. So start with Bobby.
Hello, good evening. Myself Bobby, and I'm working as counselor in Indian school for the last 10 years. And I'm enjoying my career as a counselor in our school.
Hello, this is Shweta, and I've been in this field for the last 8 years and moved to Bahrain very recently, working with Asian School as a counselor for the last 1 year, and it's been very, very enriching experience so far. So thank you.
So welcome Bobby and Shweta on this actually a kind of noble work what we are going to do in today's Radio Rang presentation. And yes, viewers, I request you all, appeal to you all to post in whatever your questions, your queries, your mindset, whatever they are asking about, the perspective you want to know from these two counselors, whether it's about you, your children, or it can be overall pandemic time, and it can be even the testing time which is going on. Now, to start with, either one of you, you can start with the answer. That means if I want to know exactly, when we say about a counselor, the term counselor, what do you exactly want to talk about counselor, and how is your life or you as an individual or as a counselor?
Okay, counseling, as everyone know, it is a profession where we help people to help themselves. That is, we are using psychological skills and is helping them to help themselves. So it doesn't mean that it is giving advice. And I started my career as a counselor in 1999, and it was a learning experience. And in Bahrain, I am dealing with the children from 4th standard to 12th standard and their parents, and helping them to solve their problems by themselves.
I think working with children is one of the most noble profession, as you have already mentioned it. But counseling become all the more, as I said, enriching experience, because you directly deal with the child's emotional concerns. You help them go through that phase very positively, and then when they come out of that concern, that troubling situation, it's so nice to see that. It's real pleasure, I guess. And I guess I'm really enjoying that. You know that. Rewarding, it matters a lot. Yeah.
Normally, it is heard, na, whether it is Shweta or Bobby, that when we talk about a counselor, the basic qualities a counselor should adopt, or maybe like they should pursue within themselves,
yeah.
Like the person should be very loving,
yeah.
Very polite, very humble, always smiling,
yeah.
You know, and kind of a listener first of all.
Yes, listening
so,
is the skill
yeah.
that a counselor should have. And patience. Skill, listening and patience is the most two skills that a counselor should have.
And of course, being a social worker is something that, you know, adds to the entire service, if we can say it. You know, you need to be ready to listen to the other person. You need to be ready to help the other person. You really need to be very, very proactive in that term. So that really counts. Yeah.
And one thing I would like to tell my viewers who are listening and watching us, that you can post in your questions, whether it is in English, in Malayalam, in Hindi or Marathi, because here you can expect answers from different languages. So if I ask you, Bobby, that when we talk about counseling, ee counseling ne patti kore okke nammal kettu kadagal undu, kore myths associated undu, appo idine patti ningalku endanu parayanullathu?
Malayalathil parayatte
parnjo
question Malayalathil ayidond Malayalathil answer cheyam. ഫസ്റ്റ് ആദ്യത്തെ ഒരു മിത്ത് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്, അതായത് കെട്ടുകഥകൾ അല്ലെ കേട്ടുകഥകൾ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് എന്താണെന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ, കൗൺസിലിംഗ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ അഡ്വൈസ് ഗിവിങ് ആണ്. ശരിക്കും പറഞ്ഞാൽ അഡ്വൈസ് ഗിവിങ് അല്ല, കൗൺസിലർ ഒരു അഡ്വൈസർ അല്ല. കൗൺസിലിംഗ് അവിടെ ഒരു ഫെസിലിറ്റേറ്ററിൻ്റെ റോള് മാത്രമേ ചെയ്യുന്നുള്ളൂ. കൗൺസിലർ ചെയ്യുന്നത് എന്താണെന്ന് വെച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ, നമുക്ക് ഓരോരുത്തർക്കും ഓരോ കഴിവുകളുണ്ട്. ആ കഴിവുകൾ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഈ പ്രോബ്ലംസ് ഒക്കെ സോൾവ് ചെയ്യാനുള്ള സ്കില്ല് നമ്മുടെ ഉള്ളിലുണ്ട്. പക്ഷേ കുട്ടികൾ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ വലിയവർ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ പ്രോബ്ലം ഫേസ് ചെയ്യുന്നവർ എന്താ പറ്റുന്നതെന്ന് വെച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ, അവർ പ്രോബ്ലത്തിലായതുകൊണ്ട് ഈ സൊല്യൂഷൻസ് ഒന്നും അവർക്ക് കണ്ടുപിടിക്കാൻ പറ്റുന്നില്ല. അപ്പോൾ കൗൺസിലർ ചെയ്യുന്നത് എന്താണെന്ന് വെച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ, അവരെ കൊണ്ട് തന്നെ അവരുടെ ഈ കഴിവുകളെ കണ്ടെത്തി അവരുടെ പ്രോബ്ലംസ് അവരെ കൊണ്ട് തന്നെ സോൾവ് ചെയ്യിപ്പിക്കുക എന്നുള്ളതാണ് കൗൺസിലർ ചെയ്യുന്നത്. രണ്ടാമത്തെ ഒരു മിത്ത് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞതാണ്, കൗൺസിലറിൻ്റെ അടുത്ത് ചെന്ന് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ കൗൺസിലറിന് റെഡിമെയ്ഡ് പ്രോബ്ലം സൊല്യൂഷൻ ഉണ്ട്. പ്രോബ്ലത്തിനുള്ള സൊല്യൂഷൻ റെഡിമെയ്ഡ് ആയിട്ട് തന്നെ കൗൺസിലറിൻ്റെ അടുത്തുണ്ട്. കൗൺസിലറിൻ്റെ അടുത്ത് പോയി കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ കൗൺസിലർ പറയും ഇന്നത് ചെയ്യുക, അപ്പോൾ അതിന് ആ പ്രോബ്ലത്തിന് സൊല്യൂഷനായി എന്നുള്ളത്. അതും വലിയൊരു മിത്താണ്. കാരണം കൗൺസിലറിൻ്റെ അടുത്ത് പ്രോബ്ലത്തിനുള്ള സൊല്യൂഷൻ ഇല്ല. കാരണം പ്രോബ്ലം ഓരോരുത്തർക്കും ഓരോ വിധത്തിലാണ് പ്രോബ്ലം. അപ്പോൾ അതിനൊരു റെഡിമെയ്ഡ് സൊല്യൂഷൻ ഇല്ല. അപ്പോൾ കൗൺസിലർ ആദ്യം ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞ പോലെ തന്നെ ഓരോരുത്തരെയും അവരുടെ പ്രോബ്ലം സോൾവ് ചെയ്യാൻ അവരെ ഹെൽപ്പ് ചെയ്യുന്നതേ ഉള്ളൂ. പിന്നെ ഒരു മിത്ത് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്, കൗൺസിലിംഗ് എന്താ പറയുക, വേണ്ടത് മെൻ്റൽ പേഷ്യൻസിനാണ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നോർമൽ അല്ലാത്തവർക്കാണ് കൗൺസിലിംഗ് വേണ്ടത്. അതും വലിയൊരു മിത്താണ്. ശരിക്കും കൗൺസിലിംഗ് വേണ്ടത് നോർമൽ ആയിട്ടുള്ള ആൾക്കാർക്കാണ്. മെൻ്റലി സിക്കായിട്ടുള്ള ആൾക്കാർക്ക് വേണ്ടത് തെറപ്പിയാണ് വേണ്ടത്. അപ്പോൾ കൗൺസിലിംഗ് നോർമൽ ആയിട്ടുള്ള ആൾക്കാർക്ക് വേണ്ടിയുള്ള കാര്യമാണ് കൗൺസിലിംഗ്. പിന്നെ വേറെ ഒരു മിത്ത് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്, ഇസ് ദേർ എനിത്തിങ് ടു ആഡ് ശ്വേത?
Though I have listened only the few terms from our field, because I don't understand Malayalam, but as you said, of course, it's not only for the mentally sick people. You know, a general person can walk in and ask and seek for the support. Let me know if you have already mentioned it. One more thing is that there is lot of stigma around
yeah.
it. Not only just because you are mental and you are going and seeking help, but in general that you are not able to cope up on yourself. That's why you are going and seeking the help. That something, that fear, that stigma needs to go away, so that even a normal, regular functioning person can walk into the counselor's office and ask for the help. You know, that stigma needs to go away.
Where is the stigma? Where is the counseling? Counseling, the things that are being said, are not all the things. കൗൺസിലറിൻ്റെ അടുത്തുള്ള ഒരു എത്തിക്കലായിട്ട് ചെയ്യേണ്ട ഒരു കാര്യമാണ് കോൺഫിഡൻഷ്യാലിറ്റി. ഇപ്പോൾ നിങ്ങൾ കൗൺസിലറിൻ്റെ അടുത്ത് എന്ത് ഷെയർ ചെയ്യുന്നതോ അത് വിത്തിൻ ആ ക്ലയൻറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദ കൗൺസിലർ ആയിരിക്കും എപ്പോഴും ഉണ്ടാവുക. അതുകൊണ്ട് കോൺഫിഡൻഷ്യാലിറ്റി ഉള്ളതുകൊണ്ട് നിങ്ങൾ പറയുന്ന കാര്യങ്ങൾ മറ്റുള്ളവരോട് എടുത്ത് പറയും അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മറ്റുള്ളവർ അറിയും എന്ന് ഒരിക്കലും വിചാരിക്കേണ്ട കാര്യമില്ല. ഇതൊക്കെയാണ് മെയിനായിട്ടുമുള്ള മിത്തുകൾ.
So in case there are listeners, there are viewers who have not understood since it was in Malayalam, let me just make it very crisp. First of all, it's like the person known as a counselor, he or she is not an advisor. They are just a facilitator, a kind of mediator between the person. It can be a person, can be a child or maybe a grown-up person. The other thing is that confidentiality, that means whatever you say, it will be between the counselor and the person, the candidate, whoever. But what we have already seen in the society is, you know, when me as a teacher also, when we find out some students are not able to cope up with the present stress, and when we speak to the parents, first of all, the parents are not ready to accept it.
Yeah.
That my child is having any issues or my child is having some problems, and they just straight away, they just ignore it, or they just try to, you know, just pass away the topic and say, no, my child is very fine.
Yeah.
So I am sure my parents also that are listening, respected parents there, teachers are there from different field and different schools are listening to us. So first thing what we need to come across is this kind of concept, what we call it as counseling. It is definitely not for a mentally sick person, and it doesn't mean that your child is sick or your candidate or your person, anybody whom you are taking to. It can be given even for a healthy person. It's just to show and make them realize that you are capable and you yourself can find out the solution. Yes. That is the entire role what the counselors all over, they are working. So we are getting questions here right now. This is from Shiba Manoj, and it is Shweta, I think you can answer.
Sure.
That what are the stress factors which are faced by the students during the online classes?
Okay, so first of all, I would, on this platform, I would like to really appreciate all the parents out there who are taking so much efforts to adjust to this, entire gamut of virtual schooling, because it's such an unexpected thing to come up in the life. No one was really prepared for it.
Yes.
Though online classes for the higher educations are still there,
right,
but for the smaller grades and, entire this schooling concept has never been virtual. So I really appreciate how the parents are learning the things, may it be Zoom or Teams or whatever mechanism your school is using. So that's one thing, it's really commendable. Parents are becoming really techno-savvy, and it helps children a lot, and even the teachers. Coming back to stresses, first is of course the technology. There are issues like devices, the network, and then audio, video, everything that actually creates a lot of problems for parents and children. Sometimes there are timing issues also. Many of parents are working and they are not able to devote that time to especially the younger ones to attend the classes. So those are little triggers, I can say, that build up this stress, because stress is generally there because of the pandemic. The stress is already there, but these triggers we need to identify, may it be device or the network or the timing issues, and we can resolve that with the mutual understanding with the school and parents. We can compromise on the timings, compromise on the if there are twins in the house, they can use the same device, there's no issue at all with that. So these are the small things which can do away with the stress that's there.
Now connecting with this, I think always we teachers, we speak that when we are talking about a child's development, their progress in the classroom, where we used to take physical classes,
yes,
we used to be present in front of them.
Yes.
We could see them, their expression, their facial, which we are all are missing. I'm
yes,
sure
yes,
you three will
of
agree
course,
with me.
Of course.
Now in this case, it's always called as a pyramid, actually. It's a triangle.
Yeah.
It's a three-tier machinery, which we can say, where the teacher, the parent and the student, we all three have to work together.
Yeah, it's a teamwork.
It's
yeah,
a work. So now in this kind of stress factors, I think Bobby can add it on. What is the role of a parent in this?
Role of a parent is, first thing, in face-to-face classroom, teacher takes that role.
Right.
But at home, sometimes parents will not be there because they have to work. And so maybe after their work, parents has to supervise what the child has done in that day. And so that role which teacher was playing, now parent is playing. And now, and the online class, as she said, I want to just add one thing, that that control is now on, during the time of class, the control of that teacher is now on the child itself. Because if parent is not there, child, most probably child also only will be there at home. So the full control of the class is now on the child, the student himself. So parent has to take care of that also. Is the child is attending the class on time, and is he doing all the work related to classroom? So parent has to take that role also, role now.
Plus, I think regarding the screen time also, already school timings are taking a lot of screen time for making a lot of screen time. Right. But then parent have to supervise the other screen engagements that child is up to, you know, may it be social media, may it be playing video games or anything. We need to curtail down considerably there so that there's no, you know, no health issues later on, because with the screen time up going up this much, there is issues on the strain, stressing your eyes, and then entire mental health of course directly has an impact. So
actually this was a question which was put across by Chinju Matthew, the stress factors and parents rule. Now when we're talking about the same thing, you know, the it's actually hats off to all the teachers, the students and the parents who took it up like this in the gap of 7 months. I mean, to be very honest and very, what to say, in front of the camera also, me myself as a teacher, we never knew the computer. And I'm sure the present generation, they are like so much of techie savvy children. They all are.
No, now what happens, I just want to add, my son who is in 10th standard, he told me last day that, Amma, I think I have started hating computer. So within the 7 months, this online class, I think they are facing some difficulties in sitting throughout the day. So there is that chance also.
They are exhausted, because even when I talk to children, they are like, ma'am, one thing you can help us is to reduce that screen time. But there's no option alternative, not there's no alternative right now, and we need not discontinue the schooling. So right now we need to just curtail the other screen times, as I said, and just focus, taking breaks from the classes in between, like having a walk around between that break. So that can help us more, stay hydrated. So, you know, that small things can help, but yeah, the children are really exhausted, that's for sure.
And parents, when they talk to us, you know, they, without the children knowing, they just give a call and say, they keep on asking, teacher, any idea when are the schools going to open? So I said, it's good the children are at home. The time for traveling is, I just want to check them. Time of traveling is reduced, you know, they need not wake up in the morning for the bus and kind of chaos that happens at home. But then the parents give a clear picture that the children are so much, what to say, they are
missing that now. They are missing that
very
now.
Badly. Yes. And due to this, many of them have gone into a very common term, what we call it as, that's depression.
Yeah.
Okay.
So when that particular term comes, here it's a question which has come up from Meera Rakesh Menon. It's a common term.
Okay.
Okay. And what we, or what she, through her, what we want to really know is, Bobby, that are we really living in such a depressed society or depressed world? And is there any way to come out of it? I think in Malayalam we call it as a vishadam, right?
Yeah. We are living in a depressed world because situation is that. This we never thought that this would happen. But it is we who decides or who creates our world.
That's true.
So if we want to continue to live in this depressive stage, okay, continue. But if there is we can see the positivity in small things, that world we can create, that positive world we can create. And telling about this depression, that sadness is not depression. Okay. Yeah. So there is a misconception that if the child or if the person is sad for a sad and he is in depression. No. Child in childhood there can be depression, children also can have depression, but there are certain symptoms and that symptoms should persist for at least 2 weeks continuously, every day that system should and that symptom should have, they should face that symptoms. The first one is sleep problems, that is it can be excessive sleep or sleeplessness, and then lack of interest in personal care. Then social withdrawal. For children, the most common symptom is they will be complaining about body aches. like headache, stomachache, and if we take them to the doctor, there will be nothing physically, nothing can be seen physically, and so they will not respond to treatment also, because there is no physical problem. So physical complaints, that is illnesses, is another symptom for childhood depression. And another thing is poor academic performance, irritability. They will get angry for no reason, okay? And for children, other thing is social withdrawal. They will not show interest in their personal care and their social activities, and sadness, then feeling of helplessness, worthlessness, and lack of concentration, then guilt.
Oh.
All these are symptoms of depression. And these symptoms, they should face or express for at least 2 weeks, continuously, every day. Then only we can call it as depression. Otherwise, we all are having some sadness during our daytime or our life. So it is called sadness. It is no depression.
If I'm talking about, you know, I always have a kind of soft heart for those tiny tots, who this is the time when they have to just get out of their house and they bundle of energy and explore and utilize their energy, and they are like totally trapped inside four walls.
Yeah.
How can being a parent, if a parent, there are many parents who are listening to us, for those tiny tots who have to sit in front of this screen for so long time, even though they have so many activities which are started by different schools, in case if they are going through any of this problem, whether it is sadness or depression, how do we identify in those small chingu pingus, you know, the tiny dots?
As it is already mentioned, the sleep patterns, your eating, the food habits, your body aches or something, is there any symptom of that sort? Then I think it's a signal, it's a red flag, it's immediate that we need to take action. But even in the general day-to-day functioning, if child is picking up fights so often, if child is, you know, withdrawing from talking to grandparents over the phone, the child is used to talk and suddenly doesn't want to talk anymore. So these are small things we need to pay attention to, because the child will not come to you and say, I'm upset. You know, these are very small kids. They'll not say that. They don't know what is sad, what is upset. They will just show you through these behaviors, and we need to pick up those behaviors. If they are too frequent, we need to really sit down and think as a parents, as a counselor, as a teachers also, what best can be done. And given a situation, there is really very limited opportunity to give them an exposure. We cannot take a risk to go and mingle with other children or even the neighbors. You know, we can't actually leave my child to a neighborhood also.
Right.
So given a situation, that's out of possibility. But what virtually we can do is to, you know, have these more conversations with family, distant family, have more time at the dinner table, you know, have more quality time. You know, it's not, people will say that we are working, we cannot give time. It's not about how much time you give, it's about how well you spend that little time at hand. Also, do you sit with them, do you talk to them about their things? Children come to me and they say, I don't want to burden my parents by saying that I'm in depression. You know, though adolescents and teenagers will use this term very loosely, but they are that mature. They're like, I don't want to burden my papa or mama by saying I'm upset. So I guess that entire onus comes on us, you know, as adults. We need to check those red flags. If my child is doing okay, you know, we need to check on their emotional health also. It's not just the school has come to doorstep or the food is there. It's not only that. The children need much more. You know, there is much more to their life than study and school. And we need to keep our antennas on, you know, if something has gone wrong haywire.
And children of adolescent age, there is a chance of self-harming.
Yes.
So that is also, what are the challenges, you know, you as counselor, you people face when they are coming to you physically? Definitely, you can look at them, you can understand from their body language, their facial expression. They may not be having an eye contact. But now, when it is everything is online, you will be conducting these courses also online. So, how do you? What are the challenges you both as a counselor face in such cases when it comes to you?
If they are in face-to-face situation, we can identify it from their physical appearance or that non-verbal communication. We can find out. But when it is online, it is very difficult. It is very difficult, and they, until they start the chat,
yes, true,
we can't identify the problem. So that is a major challenge we face now. And another challenge is that there are children, or there are cases, or who request mandate counseling, which means there are some parents, they will call us counselors and will tell that my child is having some problem, mm-hmm, so you please talk to him or her, but please make sure that I called you and told you to talk to him.
Okay.
The thing is, the child should not know that parent insisted on counseling and the teachers has not sent him. I personally goes and calls him from the class, so he is tensed by the counselor. Okay, so that is the challenge. So how I can convince him that he needs counseling? That is the major another challenge. And even if it is online, also the same, the same problem, because he don't know or she don't know why he needs counseling. So that is a challenge.
Is there almost it is seen, you know, when suppose when we were in the school, when we are teaching, and as you said, suppose you as a counselor, you just knock at the door of a particular class and you call out a student, the other students who are sitting there just give a kind of very weird look. Why the child has to go to a counselor? Is something wrong with the boy or the girl?
That is related to that myth.
That myth, yes.
Yeah.
I guess then in that case, online classes are helping. You
That's
know, there
true.
Is so much privacy. There is
very
so much
true.
Of individual space that child can connect to you with lot of ease. You know, of course, the question started with challenges, but I think virtual classes have bridged that gap also, because earlier the school was only the child will go to school and come. Parents were not that involved unless there is something wrong. But now parents have to get involved. Same way the counselors and teachers also, now we need to be little more proactive. You know, I can't sit in my cabin and say the if children has a problem, he will walk into or she will come ahead. No, you need to keep that communication lines open. You need to tell that you are there, available for all their emotional concerns. And you know, there are ways, like confidential ways to reach out. May it be email, may it be a telephonic call, or even an online session, you know. So there are ways, and the counselor's duty is to go and tell them that the service is available, or the non-judgmental person is there out who can listen to you, and there's nothing going out of that conversation. So I think that's the need of an hour.
I think the pandemic is teaching us a lot of things, and so many challenges, and we ourselves are coming out of these challenges by, you know, as you told, by finding out various solutions. And as we know, all the students are not same. Like five fingers, they are not same. There are many children, some of them are very silent, very introvert. Some they speak out. Some are very highly hyper. Some are very sober. What do you suggest? Both of you can answer for this. That there's a question which has come up from Binoj Divakaran, sir. That how to motivate, you know, if there are children who are very lethargic, very lousy, demotivated, how to motivate?
I would
these?
Like to take it up.
Okay.
Because I've seen parents, there is little that we can blame to child for this, you know, lethargy or what we call procrastination. It's a term, it's a very in term for children. No, I just don't want to do things. You know, they keep delaying things, and then parents would see it as a lethargy, as a demotivation. But as a counselor, I've always seen there is some underlying condition, there is some unexpressed feeling, some anger, some frustration that has not got vent out, a proper vent out, which is, you know, compelling a child to not do things with that energy, and then child just keeps delaying the things. So maybe it's time for us to sit down with the child and understand if there is something of that sort, you know, is there something unexpressed, so that child can vent it out and then come back to the routine, come back with that energy. So if that is not the case and child is just, you know, making excuses, we need to sit and make sure that the child has a timetable, because the routine has a is a prominent thing in child's life. If there is no timetable, if there is no structure to the child's day, unless except the school timings, children tend to be more lethargic and demotivated. So the routine, you know, that pattern has to be there for the child, which can motivate him or her to do things on a regular basis.
In this context, you know, one more thing, like when we speak about counseling, there are so many factors interlinked and interconnected. It can be communication, it can be emotions, it's the parents' role, teachers' role, the child himself or herself. Now in this case, like Shruti Binoj is asking, that what if there is completely lack of interaction. There is no kind of connection between the child or the parent, child or the teacher. That you can experience it in the classes also when we teachers are taking. There are some students, you call them how many n number of time, there is no response from them. And then we need to go with a kind of, you know, either a threatening or like we will keep you out of the class. That can be done when we are going for physical classes.
Yeah.
But right now they have an option. They can keep it online. They can say, teacher, your voice is breaking or I'm not able to unmute it. So how do you suggest, Bobby, that in case if there is lack of interaction among the students and the parents, the teacher and the counselor or the anywhere connected, how to bring the child into a talking mode?
We should try to find out the reason for that lack of interaction. Was he or she was like that from the beginning, or only now during this online classes only? So if it was from there in from the beginning, there will be some problem within the family or within the child or something else that we need to find out. If it is just started now, it may be related to something which can be of online. So there was a case that the child suddenly started stopped talking to family, and the child doesn't want to attend the class online. So when we tried to find out the reason for that, we found out that there was something, the teacher has asked the child to upload some assignment, but the child did it, but it went wrong.
Okay.
So because of that, but the teacher doesn't know that it was, she uploaded it, but it was some technical error. Teacher called her and asked her why he didn't uploaded it. So she said, yes, I did. But that the teacher asked in front of the class why, it made her feel
embarrassed
mm-hmm. and thereafter she stopped attending the class. So and at home also stopped interaction with the family. So there can be reason. So we need to find out the reason.
Okay. And this case, let us find out from Bobby itself that in case if such a case approaches you or Shweta, you, how will be the actions taken or the solutions given by you as a counselor in case of the parents approach. But before that, ladies and gentlemen, let's take a quick break and come back again on this beautiful platform of Away From Campus, where we have two counselors today and we are talking completely about you, your child, your mental health, as a parent, as a student, and let's work together. It is definitely a three-tier machinery. Stay tuned.
മൊലിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിൻ മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴിയും ഒഴുകാമൊലിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിൻ മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴി പടരാ Color your life. മൊഴുകാമൊലിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിൻ മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴിയും മൊഴിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിനു മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴി പടരാ പവിഴക്കലയും താണ്ടി നാദരാഗമായി റേഡിയോ രംഗ് കളർ യുവർ ലൈഫ്. ിലേറി മലയാളത്തിന് ഒഴിയൊഴുകും വഴിയും ിലകളിലെ മലയാളത്തിനൊഴിയൊഴുകും പടിപടരാ പവിയ കലയും താടി റേഡിയോ റംഗ് കലയോ ലൈഫ്.
Good evening and warm welcome to each one of you who have just tuned in to Radio Rang, and we are here on this beautiful platform of Away From Campus, where we are talking about a very, very healthy topic. And this is a topic concerned with you, dear parents, concerned with your children, dear parents, and of course we, the teachers and the counselors. As we already said, this is a three-tier machinery where we all have to work together in order to work and bring our child overall development of the personality. And as we all know, we have two counselors today, Shweta from Asian School Baharin and Bobby from Indian School Baharin. And it is said, when we speak about counseling, it's not sympathizing.
Yeah.
It is an empathy, a process where, you know, you listen what the others are speaking, where we hear from their perspective, where we look from their perspective, and we try to be in their shoes.
Yes.
And that is what I think it's normally missing, because what I have experienced as a teacher of the senior section, when a teenager speaks to me, they just want us to just shut up and listen. They don't want us to speak anything. And just nod our head and, you know, say yes. But that doesn't mean we are tuned into or gelled into whatever they are saying. But at that moment, if we try to correct them, they will act as a rebel and they will try to act against us. So the best part, what I have personally faced or experienced it with my teenagers, to just listen to them. Be a good listener, give your ear, and just listen to them with a beautiful smile. They'll just pour out their heart to you. So is it the same for...
Yes, listening and not saying anything at that time, that when the other person is pouring their heart out, is the best thing to do. Plus the acceptance, you know, we are not here to correct anyone. We are here to, you know, to feel the pain that they are going through and to feel that suffering first. And to accept that, yeah, it's okay to feel this way, is the first message that should go from a counselor to the child sitting next to her or the parent sitting next to her. It's okay to be angry at times. It's okay to be frustrated.
Very
it's okay to be upset. You know, that's it's okay is the mantra, you know, for the successful counseling, successful session. When you say that it's okay, you win the child, you win the parent. You know, that's there, you know. You may add.
And I think there is a very beautiful statement what we must have learned as counselor or as a teacher, that the students want us to speak what they want to listen.
Listen.
And if we speak what they want to listen, they feel, yes, the teacher understands me.
Yes.
She definitely accepts me as I am. And that is a stage where I think personally, being a teacher, that the child just completely
surrenders. Yes.
And then it's very easy for us to take out the things from a particular child.
Yeah.
Now, in this today's situation, there's a question from Sanjay Krishna Nambiar, that can students reach out to any counselor on an online platform if needed?
Yes, definitely. Yeah. Because more than ever, the counseling is needed now. Not because it's virtual, but because the stressors are from all over. You know, the parents are stressed with the financial uncertainties.
Right.
The younger sibling is not able to match up with the virtual classes. So there is the triggers are all over, and this adolescent or a teenager is not actually finding that peace with themselves. And that's where the counseling should step in. There is email option is there. You can just write down and ask for the replies, or you just pick up a phone and call the school and you want to talk to the counselor. There are, of course, different ways. And as I said already, also, we need to be more proactive. We need to reach out to children and, you know, take these thematic discussions, maybe, for example, anger management or the anxiety issues. How do you manage the stress? So we can pick up these topics and talk to children in the groups. Of course, in the group, children won't find it comfortable to respond back, but that can give them a confidence that if need be, I can reach out to this person, you know, this person is approachable. That message should go to the children. And yeah, the platform is always open for them.
In such situation, Shweta and Bobby, both of you, I would like to add upon that we are talking about students, but this stress factor, this tensions, the depression, the kind of, you know, chaos which is happening in a parent's life. यानी जो मुझे सुन रहे हैं माता पिता अगर सुन रहे हैं तो आपको भी ये पता होगा कि देर आर सो मेनी इश्यूज बाय अ पेरेंट इट कैन बी स्पेशली फादर्स आई ऑलवेज हैव अ काइंड ऑफ एम्पैथी फॉर ऑल द रिस्पेक्टेड फादर्स बिकॉज दे स्पीक वेरी लेस दे सप्रेस ऑल द फीलिंग्स एंड दे डोंट एक्सप्रेस इट आउट सो इट इट्स जस्ट इनसाइड ममाज एट होम दे आर लाइक यू नो रेडियो ऑल द टाइम दे जस्ट स्पीक आउट सो इन केस इफ द पेरेंट्स आर गोइंग थ्रू एनी काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रेस व्हाट डू यू थिंक डू पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो नीड अ काउंसलिंग
यस Because as you said, fathers are always keep everything in their mind.
Very.
They don't talk to even to the family or to their friends.
Right.
So maybe in this situation there are people who lost job,
yes.
And they don't want to go back to their place. There are people who went back to the place. So there are different problems or different troubles they are facing. So yes, they need counseling and they can take the help of counselors, either school counselors or they can go to some hospitals or other professionals and take their help. Yes, if they need counseling, yes, definitely they have to go.
So is it like a kind of decided schedule for the counseling session, especially for parents? We are talking about students, but that kind of beautiful harmonious atmosphere at home can only be provided if both parents and students both are managed and they are in a balanced state. Because if we are counseling a child, he is okay, but the home atmosphere is totally in a mess. The child will not be able to focus either in his studies, or his stress level will go on increasing. So when we talk about parents, if they are listening to me and this particular program, is there any specific scheduled program for the parents where they can go and it's like a time bound?
When it was the face to face classroom sessions, when we get the child for counseling, if we found that the problem, the root cause is in the family,
that's true.
So we definitely call them and talk to the parents and we try to give help to them. Because if that root cause is not solved, the problem of the child is not going to solve. So yes, we call them and talk to them and try to help them with that problem. Yes.
Now it is a triangle, right? Parents, teachers, students, counselors. It keeps on changing.
Yes.
In this, you both as counselors, what do you think is the role of a peer group, a friend, a companion, a sibling, maybe of same age or maybe elder to him or her or younger sometimes? What do you think is the role of a peers group?
Adolescent age, one thing is, it is for them, it everything, it is their friends.
Right.
So usually parents or family members have a complaint that he or she don't listen to us. They will listen to only their friends, what they say. So peers are everything for them at that age. So now they are missing that their peers. And so usually every day during recess or morning time, we see them having chit chats with their friends.
Exactly.
So now they may be missing all those beautiful moments. So children are facing troubles because of this too, because they don't have someone to share with their problems, because they need somebody in their own age to share with. So there are some problems or there are some issues they do not want to share with their parents or to the adults. So they are missing that moment. So peers are definitely have an important position or important place
in
that
students' life.
Yeah, recently only I have this girl from grade 12, you know, plus 2. She's approaching me and she's saying, I was hoping that school will at least reopen for
the September term,
but it's not, and you know, it's putting me off so badly. And that's where we can understand, you know, they are trying to cope up, but the pandemic is prolonged for so long that even their patients are now, you know, exhausted. But of course, peers, like friends, are important in this for the the young adults, it's of course they are special ones, and we need not always, you know, put that control and put that supervision and monitoring mode on. We can let go certain times. We can allow our children to ring up their friends and have a small brief talk.
Yes.
So often that can re-energize their tanks, and then they can come back and focus. Otherwise, if they are continuously, you know, just books and they, it doesn't help like that.
I was about to say, because in normal school days also,
yeah,
apart from the timing from 7 to 1 when they are in the school, as you said, during recess or during, you know, in between the classes, they're sharing the tiffin and passing on the eating things. My children, in case if they're listening to us, this chat, of course, they will be missing all these, because when we speak to the students, they say. But in that case, Bobby and Shweta, don't you think this situation, they can do it? After the school time also, the kids go home and they sit and chat.
Yes.
They speak, they keep calling.
Yes, yes.
That same thing they can be doing even today, even though they're not meeting personally.
Yeah, they can do it, but when there is, it is through online, there is
some limitation.
Yeah.
Plus, the time they used to spend together was much earlier, and now they just have a phone call or a video chat.
And there will be something which they want to share which cannot be shared in writing.
Yes.
So they are missing all these things.
Exactly. And there are many students whom I speak to, you know, when during the classes, because always about the subject and the topic, we need to give them some kind of energy.
Yes,
in
yes.
So I found many students who have very lucky, they are very fortunate to have their peer group just nearby.
Yeah.
But maintaining the social distancing and everything, they tell no teacher, we just go for a walk, we go for a jog. And that is the time, one and a half hour of quality time what they have when they are with their peer group, because of which, you know, they feel so relaxed when they come. There are students, I'll tell you that also, there are children who don't want to go out because they found out the time in pursuing their hobbies, their talent within. And there are many good artists and they have come up. Very good cook. There are people who write stories and all these things. So here when we are talking about, you know, these are the physical disturbances also where, but when we speak about the emotional turbulence what they're going through, a kind of a trauma, a fight within themselves. Is there anything that, and if a child goes through that emotional turbulence, that means it can be to a very extreme extent.
Emotional turbulence, we cannot say that it has an emotional turbulence, but they are facing some problems because of this current situation. One thing, as we said, they are not able to see their friends. And another thing which happened is there may be close friends, because of certain reasons they have to go back, went back to their native place without saying a goodbye to their friend. So it can be a difficult situation for certain children. And other thing is, as because of this pandemic situation, parents may be facing financial difficulties, so which it can create some difficult situation in family, and because of that, children can have some stress. So this kind of stress children face. Physical activities, they should do exercise every day, physical exercise every day. And if it is in front of, if it is in the balcony or in a place where sun light is there, it is very good for them, because vitamin D. Because now the children may be, if we test these children, a majority of them will be having problem with vitamin D.
If I'm not wrong, I think that is vitamin D which is very less in almost all the Gulf people.
Yes.
Right.
So because since February, majority of these children will not step out of their home. So there is a chance of low rate in vitamin D. So they should do physical exercise every day. And when parents are back from their work, they can indulge in some games or mental activities or chit-chat. Even though parents are busy, and they should spend some time with their children, because when they were going to school, they had their friends to share their everything with them. But now they don't have, because of that, parents has to take that role also. So yes, they should need some physical activity at home. And evenings, they can go for a walk as a family work.
Family work.
Yeah. So yes, they need it.
What about the small kids, Shweta, the tiny tots, you know?
I think, as I said earlier also,
it's very,
very,
sit at
very
one place.
Yeah, we can't take them out also and we can't ask them to sit at one place also. And that's where this family time becomes very important.
Very
so that mom, dad, the elder siblings, everyone is there. And that's where we say the peer interaction is missing because they are not going to school. But as we can give them the home versions, you know, the family versions of real interactions, like mom, dad talking to each other. The elder brother or sister
yeah.
is talking to them. They are having a phone calls to grandparents back in India maybe. So these are the little things which we have to show to the toddlers and, you know, even the very young ones, so that they know what is a human interactions. There are more people than mom, dad and sister or brother at the house. So that is the kind of manifestations we have to make deliberately at home. So,
so when we speak about this situation here, talking about their mental health, fine, their physical health, as you told the first particular word, you know, they don't take care about their personal care.
Yeah.
Now, for a small child or a child of, you know, lower classes and everything, we can make the child do it by parents taking an initiative. But how to guide the adolescent people, the teenagers, who are just ignoring their health, just ignoring in their personal hygiene and everything. And that has come up by some parents as a concern.
Yeah, personal hygiene, that we need to check whether the child is in depressed mood. So if the child is in depressed mood, I told you that some symptoms earlier.
Mm-hmm.
If the child is having that symptoms for at least 2 weeks continuously, the child should be taken to a mental health professional. Because never think that depression is a passing mood and it will be okay as the time goes. No, it needs treatment. So if the child is continuously showing lack of interest in personal care, hygiene, or sleep problems are there, and appetite is not there, yes, definitely the child has to be taken to a mental health professional. Yes.
I think one more is, there are new age parenting skills that we all need to learn now. It's because earlier children used to go to school, go out with friends, so they would like to, you know, get ready, be neat and clean and all. Now that everything is changed and there's no one else to see them, it might be putting them up, okay, what's there to, you know, get ready for. Now that parents are there, we need to understand this appreciation skill also.
Mm.
We are very, very miser in that term.
Yes.
To, you know, appreciate our children for these little things. But it's a time that we start appreciating the little things that our children
they
are
do.
Doing, you know, so that they also feel rewarded, you know, and they start doing things in desired manner. Yeah.
This I totally agree, because I think it's an Indian mentality, traditional mentality. It's kind of confuse a parent.
Yeah, if you appreciate, the child will get spoiled.
Spoils. So, but the students also, the children also know that parents do acknowledge them, they love them.
Yeah, yeah.
But the problem is when any outsider come, when the neighbors come or when the family members come, okay, how is Shweta? Shweta, wo to bekar hai, kuch nahi. This is the way.
We need to stop doing that, because the children, this age group is very, very sensitive to criticism. Even if it is in very casual manner, they will take it very seriously. They will hold on to that emotion for a long time, and that we don't want absolutely. We want our children to grow up with the positive memories. So we don't want them to feel belittled in front of any other person.
Yeah.
So let's appreciate these small things and they'll change, you know.
One thing why I'm smiling is because, you know, few interactions with my students, because I had to talk to them to get to know so that we can ask some questions to our counselors. So when I spoke to them, they were saying, teacher, you don't know. After every two sentences, after every two incidents, parents say, ende naalil, ende samayathil, mere zamane mein, no, during my days. Teacher, why parents are comparing us by their time? Time is totally different.
Yeah.
And they want us to slog like them. They came at the age of 13 to work. They started.
Yeah.
So I think that is where every student, every child will not be liking this kind of statement.
Yes.
So parents who are listening to me, I know, I mean, we all have crossed that age and come. So I think it's better we don't keep on nagging the children, saying that nyan ende cherpa kalathu nyan itra pani cheyidirunnu, ammane itna kaam kiya tha, this one. And the second thing what the students, they asked me, teacher, what do you think? I really appreciated this question from many of my teenagers. Why do you think that nowadays the suicide cases are increasing? And that too teenagers. Yeah. It's not like 40 plus, 50 plus people are doing it. It's teenagers. So I asked them, children, what do you think? So then there were many kids who are very positive in understanding that ending your life is not the solution.
Yeah.
There is life beyond that.
Yeah.
Accept the challenges as an opportunity and then fight against it. What you both have to say on this?
As I said, appreciation is one new age parenting skill.
Yeah.
The most required skill, not only for parents but all adults, is to teach our children the resilience. You know, to cope up with the situation whatsoever it comes. Because if we teach them resilience, they will know how to pass that difficult phase. And many of times what we forget is to do, you know, we always tell our children, you know, you need to be independent, you need to do your things on your own. We just forget to tell them that if you cannot do things on your own, you can always go back and seek help. We just forget that thing, you know, and then children have this performance anxiety, and that builds up. The way you said, the males and the fathers have this problem sharing, because there is this performance anxiety. If I don't earn for my family, what is there, you know? If I don't, you know, have a promotion, if I don't, if my salary doesn't go every year, it's not a good thing. No, it's okay.
It's okay.
Yeah, and that message goes from right from the childhood. And we need to stop sending that messages. It's okay to fall down, fall back. You can always go and seek the support. You know, that message should go.
Beautiful.
That resilience should be there in our teachings. You know, we call it life skills.
Yes.
If the life skills are there, even if you don't know the maths, even if you don't know the science, it's okay. You know, you need to know how to communicate. You need to know how to solve a problem. It's okay if you fail. You need to just get up and do things back. That's the message should be there.
I mean, come what may, the parents
yes.
need to instill that confidence
yes.
that we are there for you, mom
yes.
and dad.
Yes. Yes.
You do any mistake, come back to us.
Yes.
We are there to accept
yes.
you.
No, because it is the problem is, I had a child who said, I need a parent who consider me as a friend.
Right.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Okay.
Very
good. So parents, you should be the first friend of your child.
Yes.
So because mm-hmm. they wants it. They say, I want a parent who is a friend to me, which means as they share everything with their peer, their friends, they are seeking help from you as a person who can be shared with. So be a friend to them. That is what I want to say, tell you.
Exactly. I just recently read one beautiful 2-3 lines where a child is saying, I don't want a perfect parent.
Yeah.
I want happy parents.
Yes.
You know, who is there with me all the time
yeah.
to share whatever they are facing to me.
Yeah.
Because the thing is, people don't share it feeling that, no, ye toh bachcha hai. They don't understand what
yeah.
they will
yeah.
No, every
yeah.
parent has expectations from about their child. So, what they could not achieve, they are expecting that their
children
will
achieve.
So, it is creating a tension in these children that I should achieve what they could not. So
yeah.
parents, it is that your children are not your children. You know the words Khalil Gibran.
Yeah.
So your children are not your children.
Yes.
So it is a privilege you got. So give every support to them and help them to grow and develop. That is what you want, or we want as a parent.
I also wanted to mention the way we are talking about the social media or the social happenings to our children, or even if to the adult in the room and our child is sitting there, especially adolescent, for example, the death of a celebrity or a suicide of a celebrity, we need to be careful what we are talking about, you know.
Yeah.
How are we portraying our opinions about it?
Okay.
Are we saying that it's a failure that caused him to do that or this, then the child will get that message. If you are failed, this is what
yes,
you will do.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to be really, really cautious about the words that we use, the opinions that we put forth in front of our children, especially the teenagers. It's very, very crucial. They're absorbing, you know, they're absorbing everything that's happening around.
And I think Shweta connected with this, no, very important, that is responsibility, duty of a parent. When they are talking about teachers
yeah.
in front of the students, that also
yes.
they need to be. When you told
yeah.
about celebrity,
yeah.
of course your celebrity comes later, but it's the teachers who
sure.
play a very pivotal role in the life
yes.
of a child.
Yeah.
So sometimes maybe the parent from their perspective, they won't like a specific teacher, the way of teaching. Now especially as you told
yes.
in the previous talk that the parents are also observing the teacher.
Yeah, they are forming like a helicopter.
So when maybe the parents don't like the way the teacher is teaching, the way the teacher is communicating, problem in language and pronunciation and the way it is put across. So it may be like husband, wife, the father, mother, they can discuss among, but not in front of the children.
Yes.
Because sometimes maybe the child may be keeping the teacher on a very high platform and suddenly this talk may pull the dignity or the respect of the teacher very down. And it's told, Hindi and Malayalam, I think it's a common statement, when a child's footwear and your footwear matches,
you have to become friends.
You have to be friends. You cannot dominate or dictate.
Yes.
So that is what Indian culture, I think the tradition, we people are missing it because we don't try to involve the children in our talks, in our decision making.
Yes.
To what extent do you both think it's very important?
It is very important because it is told that adolescent is a period of stress and storm.
Right.
It is because they are in an identity crisis. They don't know themselves that are they grown up or still are a child. Because parents say, you are a child, keep away from this. Sometimes they say, grown up, behave like a grown up. So they are in a crisis situation whether either are they grown up or a child. So parent has to give importance to their age always, and also try to involve them in daily activities, maybe it related to family situations, financial situations, everything. Try to involve them in the family matters.
Now here, one more thing before we wind up with the particular session. This is pandemic we are talking. Post-pandemic. Do you think there will be needing the requirement of a counseling session, either for parents or students?
I think the most important thing will be a mental health post-pandemic times. More than your job and more than your health, it's a mental health. If you have that never dying attitude and hope, you'll survive that difficult time. So even parents and especially teachers also, I think more than parents and children, we need to sit back and talk to teachers, because there will be a lot of this burnout and we need to take care of that. So that they come back to the routine with more energy. And children and parents, of course, because the whole set, I don't think the new normal will go back to the routine, the earlier routine. You know, there are certain things that they're never going to go back. And that we need to take care, that we need to talk to children. We need to sit with them and tell that this is the situation, this is the given fact, and we need to exist. And how to exist with more positivity, that is the message we should, you know, discuss.
So what, when you picked out a particular term, Shweta, that's like, what is this new normal? Is there anything, we have heard normal.
Okay, so new normal is already here. We are all living the new normal. May it be a virus, maybe it's social distancing, may it be lesser of real interactions and more of a virtual associations. The new normal is already here. This is what will be the normal now. You know, and it's no more new also. We have almost
7 months.
Yeah, we are almost there. And that's where the children of plus 2 or 10th standard are facing little difficulties, because they think that they're not going to school again back ever, and their crucial year will just go like that. But we need to sit with them, talk to them that this is the situation and we do not have really much control over it, and we need to discuss with them. That's the most important, to talk to them, listen to their stories, let them express whatever feelings they have, and then we can, you know, with the mutual understanding, find a new ways to deal with it.
So I think all my dear viewers, my listeners who are listening to this particular conversation today, it's a topic which is definitely not going to end. It's going to exist in each and everybody's life, because counseling is not for a particular period. It is a life session.
Yes.
Doesn't mean that you are abnormal or your child is abnormal or mentally sick. It means this is a platform where you want to make your relation, your bonding between you and your child more stronger, and a situation where you are there to lift your child, you are there to love your child, you are there to guide your child and to support. And please expect the same from your students, your child, your children also, so that the world becomes really a beautiful place to live in, where we can actually express humanity, where we can live with smile, with happiness, and we will be ready to face any such challenges.
Yes.
Take up as an opportunity.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
And we are there for you, and you are there for us. This is a triangle, it's a pyramid, and we'll work surely better for a future. So thank you so much, both of you, Shweta and Bobby,
thank
for joining
you.
Us.
Thank you. Thank you.
With this, we come to an end of this beautiful session, dear viewers, with a hope to meet you soon in our next session. Till then, take
bye.
Care, keep smiling, and stay safe, stay home. Bye-bye. Good
bye-bye.
Night.
Bye-bye.
ായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിൻ മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴിയൊരു കാമുലിയായ് തിരകളിലേറി മലയാളത്തിൻ മൊഴിയൊഴുകും വഴി Color your life. Purukamuliyai thiragalile.